You may have been asked to find or provide more evidence in your work. For example, if you're writing an assignment or a report, someone may have made a comment saying you need to back up your claims. Well, one way of doing this is to actually find research. And research is typically found in journal articles. Now, these journal articles can be found in databases. So this session is actually aimed at finding the databases and how to use the database to find some evidence or journal articles. So the first thing I need you to do is open Chrome. Once you're in Chrome, you need to type in www.wlv.ac.uk/lib/. If you work at the University of Wolverhampton or if you're a student at Wolverhampton University. What you'll need to do is then come to the library homepage. As you see, there's a series of different tabs, but what we're looking for and what we're more concerned with is the subject resource. So click on subject resources. Okay. As you'll see here, as I scroll down a little bit, there are different links to different places. So for example, here there are databases. So this is like an A to Z of databases that you can use, which is based on the title of the database. However, let's make things a little bit easier for us. So if we go to select a subject, click on and have this drop down box. And for the purpose of this example, we're going to go to social care. So as I scroll down, I come to social care, click on social care, and we're automatically put through to social care and the key databases that the library have identified. So as you can see, there are a number of databases here that you can use. For this example, I'm going to use SOC Index, which is actually quite a very good. It's a very good database, so I would suggest using this to start with. So click on that and wait for it to open. Now, what might happen is that you might be prompted to add a username and password. Now, the username and password will be the same as your university login details or your email address and so on and so forth. So literally, you put in your username and password and sign in. This should give you access to that database. And here we go. Brilliant. As you can see, it's configured very similar to Google and Google Scholar, where you've got this bar here where you can type things in. But for the purpose of this search, and what I would recommend is that you go to the advanced area. So click on advanced search, and here we go. We have a whole lot of things that you can either choose or decline. Basically, they're filters to help you search for the information that you're looking for. So let's think of an example. Let's think about poverty. So we'll write poverty in there, the main field. Select a field. So this can mean that poverty is included in the text or in the title and so on and so forth. But for this purpose, I'm going to look at title. So I want poverty to actually be in the title of the journal article. Now, if you just put poverty in, it's going to come back with lots and lots of things that you might not be able to manage. So I do suggest that you put in another search term to help refine the search. So in this case, I'm going to put homelessness. click on search and let's see how many come up. Right, so for this example we've got 91 hits that have come up. So this search engine so far has found 91 hits, 91 articles. Now if you were presented with 91, you might think, well, that's going to take an awful long time to go through, and I would agree. So what we're going to do is we're going to scroll down a tiny bit and we're going to start using the filters to help us reduce that number. So first of all, I need full text. Okay, how much has it gone down to now? Gosh, from 91 to 39 now, as you can see. That's great. So that's brought it down considerably. But you definitely want peer-reviewed journals. So let's click on peer-reviewed journals. And that's taking us to 31 still. That's good. You could press the references that are available. I'm not going to press it for this example. But here, you'll see the publication date. Now, often your tutor might say that they want contemporary bits of literature. So what you can do is pull this to a time when you think is suitable. So for example, in this case, I'm going to choose 2010. There we go. It's brought it down to 16 articles now. Okay, so we're getting there, getting towards this manageable resource. So we want journal academic articles only. In this case, it's the same number, 13. But there might be other sort of news things or whatever. But that's just making it more focused on academic journal articles. Okay. Now, subject filters. So we can go into subject. Homelessness, United States, neoliberalism, poverty, etc., etc. I'm going to leave that for now. Publication, that will talk about the different journals that these articles are in. I'm going to leave that. Publisher, which publishers actually provide the articles. I'm going to leave that. Language, that's a really important one. In this example, we've got English, but you might find that there are other languages there. So obviously pick the one that you can understand. So I assume that will be English. So let's go into this other filter. As you can see, there are a number of choices, but in this case, we're going to go to Great Britain because I'm only interested in poverty and homelessness in the UK. Now, what the search has done for us is actually honed it down to one article. This is great. But obviously, if you're looking for more articles, what you would be doing now is going to a different database to see if those other databases actually provide other literature, which it's quite sort of common that might happen. Anyway. So, first thing you do when you have a list of all these articles that have been filtered is read the title. Now, that's your first indicator to see whether or not the article is good for you or what you want to use or potentially you could use in your work. So, the everyday costs of poverty in childhood. Oh, for the purpose of this is great. So, what I'm going to do is I want to find out a little bit more information. So, I'm going to put and click, PDF full text. Now this will take you to the article itself. And what we're going to do once the article comes up is to actually read the title, make sure it's the same article, and then have a look at the abstract to see whether or not that further detail in the abstract, which is just here, makes it relevant. So I'm happy with the title. I'm going to read the abstract here. I'm happy with that. Let's make it a little bit larger and scroll down. So I'm happy with the abstract. So I'm going to keep it. And now I'm going to start reading the introduction. Once I've read the introduction and I'm still happy with it, I will now continue reading the article, making notes. But if I'm not happy, I will discard the article and start my searches again using a different database, because we only found one on this subject. So you can now save that and upload it or print it to whatever you wish to do. And that would be the first start in finding the evidence that you need for your work. When you want to actually go to another database, you can go back up to the databases and perform the same task again. So for example, if we come to Academic Search Complete, you'll notice when it opens that the web page, this page, looks exactly the same. However, it's got a different title. The advanced settings will look exactly the same, but use this in the same way as I've just shown you, and then you may find another set of articles, because not every database will have everything. So I strongly suggest that you do this when you're looking for articles, not just going to Google, because Google won't provide you with everything. Google does not have everything. Google Scholar's a good start, but using these databases is the way forward. Good luck, keep going, and thank you very much.